I've been playing around with the King Renko bar type and using it with the solar wind indicator, and I've found that the strengthening signals on the solar wind indicator are extremely good on the King Renko. I've got the King Renko bar type with a brick size of 16 and a trend threshold of 4. And for the solar wind indicator, I've got all the base settings, multiplier trend of 2, multiplier stop of 4, didn't change any of this. Under the alerts, I unchecked the trend start and the trend pullback. The only signals that are printing are the trend strengthening, so I've got those checked. And something else that I really like about ninZa indicators, let's say I find a signal like this on one of my ninZa indicators that I really like, but I'm not sure how to incorporate it into my current system, or I don't want to take up the chart space, I can check this box to enable a pop-up. So every time a signal prints, even if this is on in the background, I will get a pop-up window alerting me to the fact that a signal has printed on this Renko chart. It's a really great feature that's on, I think, pretty much all of the ninZa indicators. But this is the afternoon session from today. We're getting a 25 point move there on the NASDAQ, a 40 point move there, a 50 point move. Then once 2 p.m. hits, we just get a bunch of long strengthening signals and price just went up the rest of the afternoon. And then check out earlier this morning, right before 9:30, nice move up. Nice move down, strengthening signal up, two strengthening signals to the upside. That's just from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. Here's 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. Some more strengthening signals to the upside, and then a bunch to the downside. This is yesterday at the close. Strengthening signals to the downside, and then a bunch of bullish strengthening signals on the solar wind all the way into the market close. Here's yesterday at lunchtime till 2 p.m. These are some really great signals with the King Renko and the solar wind. Here's earlier in the morning. It's kind of a choppy morning. Then a little bit after 10 a.m. got some nice signals to the upside. Here's pre-market before the big news release, which, you know, you're probably not going to be trading at this. This entire chart is all just from 8:30, like 1 minute. No way you're going to trade this. But afterwards, we get a signal to the downside, another one at 8:32, another one at 8:46. You know, and this entire down move for 45 minutes after the big news, all we got was strengthening signals to the downside. Pretty impressive. Here's the day before on Monday. This is 9:30, New York Open. We get a short signal for over 10 points. This signal got stopped out. A couple nice ones to the downside. Started to get a little choppy there. And then the rest of the morning, a bunch of great signals to the upside. So instead of enabling all the different signals on your solar wind, you might want to try just enabling one of the signals. Maybe just focus on one of these three signal options that comes with the solar wind and finding which one works best for the instrument and the time frame that you trade. I can show you how this pop-up feature works. So here I've got my Renko chart with the solar wind strategy and the strengthening signals and the pop-ups enabled. I can minimize this window. I can be trading on my time-based charts. And then I will get an alert. I will get a pop-up from the solar wind indicator on the Renko chart, alerting me when there is a strengthening signal. So that way I can be trading my regular system if I don't have room for a new chart. And I can also see if it correlates with a time-based chart and maybe some other support and resistance that I'm using. and I can have that renko chart in the background, minimized, out of sight. But if I ever get a signal from the solar wind, a strengthening signal, I'll have a pop-up that pops up. There we've got another strengthening signal. So these last two signals, I didn't have to be looking at the chart. I was just able to get the pop-up alert after enabling it on the solar wind indicator. So just some more creative ways to use ninza indicators and the King Renko bar type. So many different ways you can use and customize these indicators to your own trading style and to the particular instruments that you trade. I hope you got some great ideas from watching. Best of luck in your trading.